Hey, nerdlings!
What up, nerdlings?
Do you nerd for Suomo? That sounds like a food.
I think
that
it sounds like good. A drink to me.
A drink?
Like an energy drink.
Have you had
your Suomo today?
I tell you what, let's go out and get some drinks and food.
This is Tom and Lizzie, collecting all the things, searching from here to there, finding comic book tables, house Legos, and action figs, retro gaming, amiibos, and imitrants. Watch as they collect them all. Tom Lacey collecting right now.
For real though, what is Suomo?
Southwest Missouri MicroCon, put on by St. Louis Comics.
Nicely done.
Comic convention? Check. Teen Titans? Check.
And it was nicely done because they had a nice little convention center, which I think is always perfect for conventions like this, because you always have like that one room, but then like you've got the hallway, you know, where people can kind of go and mingle. So maybe they're not in your way where you're trying to look at the tables. There were obviously comics.
Yes.
Comics galore. You had comic bins that were like, you know, $1, $2 to $3, up to $5. And then, of course, your more expensive stuff. Some were sorted, some weren't.
I am a non-sorter person. If it's not sorted, I'm not giving you the time of day. I'm sorry, that's just the way I am. I want them to be alphabetized. And then, you know, if you can't put them in Spider-Man, X-Men, whatever, I get that. But at least have them alphabetized so that I can go to the S's or the X's or the M's or whatever and find my comics rather quickly.
But if you don't mind digging, if you don't mind hunting, places like this are fantastic places, because these are the types of people who collect just like you do.
Yep.
But these are the kinds of people that don't want to haul that back to their car. So you start picking up a whole bunch of books, and they're like, you know what? I'm going to cut you a deal on that.
Yes.
They did have some local talent on hand, meaning either you could find some books and then go over to their table and get some autographs, or you could just go to their table and pick up some of the books straight from them. Jumping back to the hunt of comics, though, aside from non-sorted things, you discovered there was one other problem.
Yes. Apparently, even though there's a rather large run of Spider-Gwen comics, there are only 5 in existence of any of them. And I have all 5 of those one particular ones. And the rest of them just don't exist.
Will I have them or will I not have them?
I went to several different tables. I was lucky enough to find a stack of Spider-Gwens at a couple of different tables, but I had them all but one table. One table didn't let me down, and I found one.
I found one. I finally found one I didn't have yet.
So I was able to add this one to the collection, and I will keep hunting for the rest of them. I know they exist. I've read them. I actually thought I was going to leave a comic book convention without a comic book.
She was not the only one who picked up a comic. We got to meet an incredible artist.
Oh my gosh, I think I found my new favorite artist.
Ryan Kincaid. I am definitely leaving a link in the description below. We could not have left his table without something, and we got a couple somethings.
Yeah, Tom and I will both agree. When we look at like drawings and artists and everything, we'll either like the face is really good, but then there's something wrong with the body. It's too, the proportions aren't right, or the costume just doesn't look so great, but then the face is just ew. Right?
What she's getting at is Ryan drew the whole package.
He did. It was everything. The face was perfect. The body was perfect. The proportions.
I believe what drew our eye to his table was actually this White Widow print. Now, he had the print up behind him, but it's also a comic cover, as you can see. And there is an interesting story that goes along with this image.
So, the story behind our White Widow cover is Jamie Tyndall created a character for all of us to work on. A fun thing for all of his friends to do covers and interiors and just a fun story to tell. It's an awesome book if you guys haven't seen it. Anyway, so my wife has just started getting back into going to shows with me. And she really decided to dress up as the character of the White Widow. So going around taking pictures in Chicago at C2E2, Jamie Tyndall decided to snap a picture of my wife as the White Widow in a homage to Rolling Stones' Janet Jackson cover, which it turned out looking like that. Now, everyone liked the picture so much that they said, why don't you turn it into a actual comic book cover? So after a little while, and her agreeing to doing it, that's what we did, which you have over there. And yes, those are my hands holding my wife, because if not, she would probably punch somebody. Not probably, she would definitely punch somebody. And that's how that cover came to be.
His wife posed for the picture, and then he put that picture to good use. And you see it all the time, but it was done really well here because she's very expressive, and that kind of makes it fun. You know, there's like a flirtiness to it. You don't quite know, is she surprised? Does she like it? Does she not like it?
I was just gonna say, is she glad that those are hands she knows?
Maybe she's wondering, are those hands that I know? But it's just a fun cover, and the comic. We're looking forward to checking it out. It looks like this is issue number 3, so we're going to have to get caught up. But we did have him sign it, of course. You don't buy a comic with the cover done by the artist while talking to the artist without getting it signed.
The other neat thing that we really liked about this one was the only way to get this cover was through him.
So if you're looking for this cover and you don't see him at a con, you're out of luck.
Aw, gee.
The next comic that we got from Ryan Kincaid was
Antoinette.
Now, this was a comic that we both agreed on because, first of all, the premise of the storyline sounds so fun. If you like your history, then obviously you may be a little familiar with the ultimate fate of Marie Antoinette. It seems like...
She likes cake.
Let them eat cake.
Basically, he said, in the small of it is, think of the Headless Horseman, but Marie Antoinette is kind of the Headless Horseman, and her weapon of choice is the guillotine blade on a chain. The other thing that I thought was really neat about this was, this reminds me a whole heck of a lot of Grimm's Fairy Tales from Zenoscope. And he goes, ha! I draw for them! So, obviously, I liked him before I knew who he was.
Although, I will say, it is kind of a shame we weren't paying attention that he was going to be there.
Yeah.
And didn't know that he had drawn some of the Grimms.
I would have gone through some of my Grimms.
Exactly. Brought him a stack worthy of Cullen Bunn.
Yeah.
Now, there were a lot of different covers to choose from. We went with this one because she's on the table. You've got the blade right up at top, and she's about to lose that pretty little head of hers. There was an alternate cover that was very similar of this, where the head was already gone, but the problem is you don't get that great face that he draws.
Well, and the other thing was, it was the exact same one, but all the colors were very muted, and so we wanted to go for the more bright, vibrant, lively colors.
And of course, that one is signed as well. Inside the front cover, you can see all of the alternate covers here. And right here is actually the one that was our favorite, but it was a little out of our price range for a comic, so we didn't jump on that one. The last bit of love that we were doling out for Ryan Kincaid came in the form of buying his art book.
And the reason that we popped on this one versus actually getting some prints, because you're probably saying, what? You love him so much and you didn't get any prints? Was because we couldn't decide. There were too many. So we decided to start with the art book, and then the next time we see him, then we'll try to start narrowing it down a little bit.
Signature.
Gotta get that signature. One of the favorite things that he said he really enjoyed drawing was his Red Sonja pictures.
As you can see, much Spidey love, and ooh, Spidey's gonna get the love from Mary Jane or Black Cat. Yeah, I'm a little bit of a sucker for Bowsette stuff.
I will say, he didn't have a print of the Bowsette. We might have actually gotten that one if he'd had that one there. And he doesn't just draw the ladies, he draws the hunky men too. Check out that face.
Nope, I'm tearing that one out of the book.
Don't you dare.
So as you can see, this might have been a pretty good pick. If you can't decide on which print to go with, because you just got all kinds of images, and he's hitting so many different fandoms, like Spider-Gwen.
My little Spider-Gwen, and some Poison Ivy over here, and some Batman.
with so much art on hand. Of course, we did end up with one print. Fortunately, we were able to decide on something here.
Yes.
Now, this is by Caesar Crawford, and we did pick up a fun little book. I love when they do these because it's like a little micro comic, kind of gives you a taste of their artwork and everything and the stuff that they do.
But the art print that I got was more of my Spider-Gwen love.
Nice. That is a cool piece.
Yeah, I love this one. Her face is just right. She's not too over-proportioned on all of her features. People like to give Spider-Gwen abs for some reason, and I just don't like that. But this was awesome. It was, you know, she's trying to get that bomb there, and she's all beat up, and, you know, it just looks good. He did sign it. It's just black on black, so you can't really see it very well.
It's a local convention, so of course we ran into our buddy Ellis from Watching Ellis, and he had some fun stuff. Of course, he always has some really cool toys on hand.
Yeah.
Edge Retro Geek Out, this is for you.
Sometimes he's got some fun game stuff on hand, too. This time, he had a fantastic Zaxxon mini arcade machine.
It looked like it literally just came out of the factory.
It did.
It was so pristine.
So, it looked great. It even worked. I got to play around with it a little bit.
What'd you find?
It's Zaxxon. This is pretty cool.
Oh, I got hit. I was very, very tempted to add that to the collection.
The batteries that thing took, though.
Oh my gosh. You guys remember D batteries?
I don't think anybody knows what D batteries are anymore.
Nobody remembers batteries that big.
It's insane.
It's so crazy. It's impressive how clean it is.
Yeah, I was mind blown when I came across it.
And he was not the only person who had toys. Oh my gosh. This may as well have been a toy convention with as much stuff as on hand.
Oh yeah.
Lots of vintage stuff. Stuff that we haven't seen in years.
Or have never seen. There was a table full of a whole bunch of Spider-Man toys. And I couldn't help but thumb through those and found some really neat stuff. But they were a little over my price range for what they were.
The toy vendors on hand were definitely willing to make a deal, though. If you found a couple of things, they'd usually bundle stuff up for you. We could, you can kind of hear them talking to other buyers. And there were all kinds of conditions, of course, the carded stuff, but then just some loose figures. If you want a fun little display piece or something, or maybe you need to reenact that battle with some Ninja Turtles or Masters of the Universe figures. This one here may be starting up some fun new battles with her two toy pickup.
I did. I got two new toys, and they're ginormous.
Look at the size of this guy.
I got a big old Gambit right here, and he's very puffy-chested. He's very proud of himself, and also very flexible.
Well, that's Gambit for you.
But I got a Gambit, and I got a Scarlet Spider.
I'm the Scarlet Spider, and I'm too self-conscious, so I'm going to put a t-shirt over my onesie, but not pants.
And the funny thing about this was I was actually at first kind of making fun of him, but then the more I looked at him, I was like, no, I kind of want him. These actually remind me of like the old G.I. Joe, like dolls.
The originals, yes.
And another reason why I would say that is when you take off Scarlet Spider, it kind of looks like, yo, Joe. I don't ever remember Scarlet Spider being a blonde. The other thing is they are 100% like, there's muscle underneath the suits. Some, I would say on Scarlet Spider, maybe a little too much thigh muscle going on here. The other thing that I think is hilarious, he's got all the pouches like Deadpool, but on his ankles. Like you do, I guess. What the heck?
They having a splits off?
Who can do the splits better? Me or you?
I am you.
Oh.
Oh, now it's the clone thing!
The The other thing is they don't have any shoes on. They've just got their little tights on, and their feetsies are kind of rubber. They do bend at the knees. They bend at the wrist. They've got a lot of good articulation to them. You know, you can take their clothes off if you want to.
So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every guy I see. Hey, big spender.
They're just, you know, muscle on muscle on muscle. Look at that muscles. He's squeaky like a Barbie. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe this is just Ken doll from Barbie, and they stuck some clothes on. But I will say, Nerdlings, if you know what, like, line this is or brand these big ones are, because I have some that I thought these were part of that line. And when I got them home, they're about this tall to these guys. Oh, wow. So anyway, I thought it was a certain line, but it turns out it's not. So if y'all know what line these are, because I would like to know if there's other ones. Because like if there's more X-Men or more Spider-Man figures, I would love to have them. The other thing I just now noticed is, did you see how googly eyes he is? His eyes are literally wall-eyed.
Sorry, sir. Doing my best.
I'm just gonna sit there and rock you back and forth.
Life don't get much better than this.
You know, I really had a lot of fun with this convention. It was a nice, smaller convention, which meant that it didn't take a full day to go through the floor. You know, we actually managed to, I think, cover the room about three times.
Mm-hmm.
So it felt good to not feel as if you were leaving anything behind.
Or miss anything.
Right. And we got to see some great familiar faces. Josh from the Comic Cave was there. Actually, he had given us the
heads up.
He's
the one who let me know about the whole convention. So thanks, Josh.
The whole point is, though, Nerdlings, keep your ear to the ground, because whenever you hear about events like this, mm-hmm. go show them some love. The ones putting it on, St. Louis Comics, we have dealt with them in the past at other conventions, buying books from them.
Yeah.
And they always, they're so nice. They always give us fantastic deals. Of course, this one usually leaves with a huge stack of comics, so how can they not?
Yeah.
But they did a really great job. Get some weird muscle men toys, because why not?
I love my new boys.
That's all right. I'm digging these girls. I'd buy that for a dollar. Hey, get your grubby hands away, Cajun. Get out of here. I don't know where your hands have been.
They've been all over Scarlet Spider.
As always, Nerdlings, if you happen to like the video, give it a like. Drop some comments down below about any of the cool stuff you saw here, or let us know what you've been picking up lately. Hit that notification bell, become a subscriber, find out where we're going next, what we're finding next, you know, maybe check out a new artist yourself, or look for some muscly guys.
Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Head over to TeePublic, because we've got merchandise over there, and if we like it,
we nerd it. Even when their heads are coming off!
Our pets' heads are falling off!
Back to the splits.
That's all I can do.
Hey, whoa. I am so sorry. Bye, Nerdlings. Helicopter attack!
Why are you getting hit when I'm hitting him?
Hold for yawn. Hey, Future Tom, that's where you put it in. You got that right.
That was fast talking.
The next... Oh, were you yummy?
Yeah, hold for yawns.
I should have kept going to see how long you could stifle it. That was really awesome! Just so excited. Thank you, because I could not remember
I know.
Name. I was like... I get her sometimes.
Just look like a dying fish out of water. Stop it, I'm trying to compose myself. Did she wash her hands or not, folks? Okay. Ah. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Is that it? That's it. That's it. Yep. Okay. Let me try it again. Ready?
Get your print. Got him.
Oh no! Scarlet Spider fell over.
Are you taping her?
It's a video.
Oh, it's a video.